we learn logarithm? How it helps? No idea?
It makes our calculation easy.
How?
And
very good. This makes calculation easy. But how? This what it does actually, this converts multiplication into addition. Addition, no? The table, log table, we just add two numbers, then we get third number, then we take anti-log of that and we get the, and we, what is that? We convert that multiplication of large number into addition. Addition is easy. So, that was the objective of logarithm. So, logarithm was devised 500 years ago, because that time they are more concerned this period. You can see this Kepler and his earlier fellow Napier, those are dealing all with this physics. So, mathematics is not isolated with physics actually, it is a requirement from physics, and they have developed this logarithm. And then came imaginary number. As you told, what for imaginary number used? Minus 1, yes, you told minus 1, root over of minus 1, but where from it come, and what can anybody tell about any characteristics of complex number, anything? 2 minute, 3 minute lecture on, already you have encountered, no, complex number. What it does, what is advantage, disadvantage, where from it has come, where it was required. I should say that in class 3 first we used complex number, you will surprise. We are not knowingly done it, we have unknowingly we have used complex number in class 3 onwards, okay. And next, where we encountered the real problem where we required complex number in class 6 or 7.
When we multiplied something and we get negative of that value, example square of something, we get negative value. So, we get we have
Mike,
to, we need a specific value for that. Suppose a square is a square is equal to minus 1. So, what is the value of a? We are curious about that. So, we need to
know. But first requirement, you are right, it is like that only. But very precisely, if you tell, when we face the problem of solving quadratic equation, when this quadratic equation, no, the what is called discriminant, the root over b square minus 4ac, if it is negative, then there is no solution. And we faced this in class 7, I think. Okay. And then somebody, actually this was an issue for 100 years, 105, 200 years, 500 years. It was known, this is an issue known to this Aryabhatta in 1300 AD, and before that Chinese people, there have the documentation on this, and many people thought it cannot be solved, and and we should not try for that. But problem was known that long back, 13 years ago also people facing this issue. But one fellow 300 years ago, he suggested some numbers that use something instead of minus 1, root over minus 1, if we take it out minus 1, then we can make a square root, no? Negative part is the problem. So, if I can take negative part, then everything becomes easier. So, he took that negative part minus 1, if I multiply, then it is number becomes positive. We take out and we square root that, and in that he has termed it as I, but it was not readily accepted. That was also debated for long time, opposed, criticized, And finally, 100 years, 200 years later, people thought that it may be a good solution. They started using 1, 2, 3, and they found it is important, and then we have started this using imaginary numbers. And imaginary numbers actually, why I am telling it is we have used in class 3, where we used. Simply we think you just multiply. We have learned this number line in class 3, 4, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 3. If you multiply 3 into minus 1, what will happen? Minus 3, it will come here, minus 3, is not it? So, this point comes here. Okay. Actually, what happens? It rotates same plane. In same plane, this point rotates here and comes here, and we tell it is we have multiplied with minus 1. Is not it? Up to this, no issue. But if we multiply with square root of this, what will happen? Three will move here vertically, is not it? So, when we multiply with minus 1, it rotates 180 degree. When it we multiply with root over of minus 1, it rotates the number to 90 degree. So, it is a rotor, it is a rotor. Imaginary number is a rotor. Actually, in higher class studies, if you cannot visualize that I as a rotor, complex number mechanically if you read it will be very complex. But if you see this, it is a rotor like that, then it is a very easy, because here you are dealing simultaneously x and y, and how this x and y changes, that acts on based on rotor, is not it? That we will discuss in next classes, but this is a thing. So, imaginary number when added with real number, it becomes a complex number. Here is also an ambiguity. We know that we cannot add a mango and a banana. Addition requires same kind of thing, but here without any doubt we use a real number adding with a imaginary number, and we make a complex number, and nobody questions that. But it is a fundamental flaw in addition. But this flaw makes our life so simple, we have adopted it without any questioning. You understood my point? Actually, these are the issues. Actually, if we are not clear, then math will become hard. If you understand these subtle differences, then math is very easy. Okay. And then quaternion. Quaternion actually, this is a complex number. Complex number in x and y direction, actually what I should say. But quaternion, they are not limiting this imaginary numbers in one plane, not in only y plane. They extended it to x, y, z plane. This is a one real number plus one imaginary number in x axis, one imaginary x plane, another in y plane, and another is z plane. So, combinedly it is a quaternion, and this number also exists. It is not in your syllabus, but it is there. And vectors is also a number. Vectors, how it helps, why it is required? Vector is a number which what we are doing in one go, we are giving two means number is a simple number. Here magnitude matters. Here with vector we are dealing with magnitude as well as direction simultaneously. So, that they are making many problems very easy to solve. So, vector at the same time it is, as I told that complex number, it is handling real part and imaginary part simultaneously. Similarly, vector making simple for this giving magnitude as the direction. So, both simultaneously we are doing, but without visualizing all these things mechanically, if you go vector solutions, no, it will become very complex to solve. But if you remember that it is giving simultaneously magnitude and direction, then it is helping you. So, it is making math simpler. Complex number, actually math, it is making math simpler, but complex number makes a our life more complex, is not it? But if you know the underlying principles, it will really make mathematics easy. And matrices, you are handling group of numbers, and group of numbers casually, if I tell, it is meaningless, means you will not realize what is the difference between this normal handling a number and matrices. Matrices arises there, everything I told you that when I was talking about nature, everything is in mathematics. What I told, that everything is having a pattern, nothing is random, they have some symmetry or something is there. So, you can represent anything. So, everything when it is a pattern, this pattern can be captured in matrices, it will have a shape. So, matrix can help in group of numbers, group of properties, you can simultaneously capture in matrices. So, matrix is not a simple as a collection of numbers, it gives you a to identify the pattern behind that. And this conic section, if you try to solve by remembering these formulas, no, conic section, you know, x square plus y square is equal to r square. So, this is a formula for a circle, but x square plus y square plus twice x plus 3 y plus 7 is equal to something. What will be that? This formula? I will write. So, I am telling the start discussing all these points, it will be become very x square plus 3 x y plus y square plus 3 x plus 5 y plus 7 is equal to 0. Now, what is the equation? This may be a circle. Circle x square plus y square is a circle, and 7. So, this is a circle, but it may be a conic section, it may not be a circle, but it can be a circle also, depending on this x y values and x and y values separately. So, if it is a circle and this is a very complex algebraic relationship, what is that meaning? This circle is not its own place, this circle has been shifted and rotated. When it rotates, this part appears when this circle rotates, okay? This wheel is moving, you are modeling a car wheel which is rotating. So, this formula will be same for rotation circle, x square plus y square something, but when it is rotating, then all x and y will change from initial point. Okay? So, x y will add in that formula, and then it will translate also, means rotate means it will move. When move, then it will move x and y direction. So, x and y will add. So, this when it normal circle is rotate or moves, then automatic this analytical formula gets complex, is not it? So, I do not know whether it is a circle or not, I have to do so many things to understand whether it is a rotated circle or displaced circle or something. But if you do for this in these matrices, matrix having a pattern that will never change, okay, single matrix. And whether it is rotated or not, only these coefficients or elements will get changed. But you know that what elements do what, matrices having A1, A1, A2, A13 like that, no, elements. And if you know that what elements represent what, then matrix will be same. So, you know, it is a shifted circle. Okay. So, matrix can be so, make everything so simple. So, it is otherwise said when I am teaching mathematics and you are struggling to learn calculus. In actual parlance, in modern day, it is more important to learn matrix than calculus. But again, you have to pass the exam, so you have to read the calculus, that is another issue. So, with this and set is all group of something, last number. And this numbers is this mainly this four operations we do, and we learn this also in class 5-6 I think. This is what I call closure law, associated law, and commutative law and distributive law. Apparently these laws are very simple. What it says, commutative law. Anybody familiar with commutative law, or for the same say closure law? What is
tell? A plus b equal to b plus a, commutative law.
Or closure law. Closure law is the all four laws are very easy, but closure law has some implication that I want to highlight. Closure law is telling if we add two integers, then the result will be
integer.
A integer. The two real number, result will be real number. In those cases, it is a following closure rule. But when you divide two integers, divide, then you may get a fraction or rational number. So, it is division not following.